Right, that Stockton Swing has a very nice little song called Letting Go. We've got two musical men here with a heritage between them. Your combined ages must be somewhere around 159. This is Shea Hutchison.
100, yeah.
Shea Hutchison, ex of the Melody Maces, Melody Aces. And indeed Hugo Duncan, ex Hugo Duncan. How are you doing, Shea? You must have been in America a few times here, Dave.
I've been in America 8 or 9 times with the band.
Yeah?
Yeah.
And did you always enjoy that?
Oh, of course, of course.
You probably met a lot of people over there asking about home and Brown about this.
80% of them would be Irish immigrants somewhere or other.
Yeah. Is this your father here, Hugo? Who's this man here?
I just met James today here. James is just out of hospital.
Is he? What's wrong with him?
Yes, he had a coronary.
Had a coronary.
Why do you wear your belt down there?
Slaps it. That's it.
Oh, it just slipped then. What about you, Hugo? Do you be a frequent visitor here? Do you like it here?
Very nice up here, isn't it? Mm. I wish I could get over to America as often as Shea does. Yeah. I only got over once and never want to be back again.
Of course, there's no signs of your retiring now. Of course, I mean, have you retired, Shea?
Not at all.
You're still battling.
How dare you?
I see your mother over there.
She's the fine lady. She is. She's here.
She's 37 next month.
37 or there, but plus that.
Come on, have you seen this man? There's a man in here I want you to meet, and his name is Gordon Calhoun. He's a wheelwright. See, one of the things about the Old West was they had to make all their own stuff, of course, and nothing was able to come down here. Come on in, we see this man.
Hi, Gordon.
Can you get us in here? Gordon, what about you, kid? Are you all right?
How you doing?
Now, I believe a lot of the stuff that you make here is for use here in the park itself and to replace old worn things like wheels and all kinds of stuff. Tell me mainly what you do.
Yeah, replace the wheels and different parts for the horse-drawn vehicles here and make a few wooden buckets and churns and barrels, stuff like that that's needed.
And these are all, what kind of tools have you got here?
Well, I still use the traditional hand tools, they're like spoke shaves.
Now, funny enough, you should mention that, wasn't it amazing that I knew how to lift this spoke shave? Did you ever see like a Hugo in your life?
Right, I used to use one of these myself.
Did you?
Yeah.
I thought you were too young for that. Yes, of course, these are ordinary woodworking tools, because there's the wooden plane.
Yeah, there's the ordinary plane here.
Now, do you sell any of the stuff here in the park itself?
Yes, we sell buckets there and churns and barrels, things like that there. We'd sell off a few, yeah.
Where's your buckets? Have you got buckets here?
Yeah, there's a few there.
Lift that, Hugo, do you see what they're... That's a fair-looking bucket there. How much would you sell that to me?
The makings of a churn there, yeah.
It's a churn?
It's a churn and a service.
It's
a very small churn.
Yeah.
How many little chairs?
There's a few chairs.
Do you think I don't know a bucket when I see one? It looks like a bucket to me.
Yeah, it is.
So these are the type of things that people would have used. This is the way that people would have operated. And yeah. you use no modern appliances at all in any way.
No, you use all hand tools and make the things the old way.
Okay, right. And what's give us a look at that plane. That's like the one I used in the Christian Brothers. It sort of reminds me, it just goes to show you how advanced we used to use little planes like that.
Nice, isn't
that amazing? Right.